Carol Williams has a new way to work out.
Let's face it, we're all busy. It's not always convenient to go to the gym and not always cheap either. Tonight, meet a Crescent Springs man who's found a solution, aerobic house cleaning.
Hi guys, welcome to aerobic house cleaning.
Steve Markovich wants to help you shape up, and he's producing a workout video to show you how. It's a way to clean your house and work out at the same time.
Most people have to clean your house, so rather than looking at that as a drudgery, I look at it as an opportunity to get some exercise.
Just to a normal lunge.
Steve says just vacuuming your carpet can be great for your quadriceps, if you know the proper technique.
As I keep my hips low to the ground and shift my weight with the vacuum cleaner.
Oh, yeah.
And then back. I know.
There's not many men who could do this, you know.
Bingo.
Steve challenges the men out there to pitch in and try it.
They ought to try it, because it's a killer workout.
Want a washboard stomach? Wash your kitchen floor.
Turn to the side a little bit, hit the oblique. Turn to the other side, hit the other oblique.
For your calves, try this.
Real simple, not rocket science. But boy, it does work.
Here's a workout for your arms and legs.
We might have a leg in front, and to the side, and to the other side.
You can even kickbox in your kitchen.
I'll open the cabinets with my feet.
And who needs weights? A few jugs from your refrigerator will do the trick.
We can tell that it does work a bicep.
Sure does. Steve says aerobic house cleaning lets him spend more time with his family. At 47, he now wants to be a stay-home dad for his daughters, Lucy and Carly.
First thing is that gets me time with my kids. That's first and foremost. I'm going to be there for them.
Steve's wife, Charlotte, is all for it.
He totally believes in it, and it is really how we clean the house.
Really, why as hard as I possibly can.
Steve works like a maniac and tries to get this big workout in every time he cleans the house.
Pick it up.
Steve admits, this one's advanced. Now, every woman is not going to want to do this.
No, that's correct.
And I'm not sure that I couldn't do this in vacuum at the same time. But like anything, what you get out of it depends on what you put in. For Steve, it works.
This is an opportunity where you're saving time, you're saving money, and you're getting in shape, and you're with your family. So it's a win-win all the way around.
If you're wondering, does it work? One health journal says that housework gives you the same benefits as moderate aerobic exercise. Steve has credentials in wrestling, gymnastics, and karate. But as always, check with your doctor before starting any workout. For more information, go to our website, cincynow.com, and click on Healthy Living. With photographer Steve Sula, for Healthy Living, I'm Carol Williams. Yeah, check out Steve's biceps. Those were big.
So I guess it is working. So why isn't my place cleaner and I'm in better shape?
I don't know.
I need to go home and clean now.
You know, Carol was perfect for that story, too, because Carol, if you were listening, she is the workout queen.
Yeah,
that's for sure. She is in good shape.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Steve Markovich, and I created aerobic house cleaning a number of years ago. Today, what I'm going to show you is how anyone could get either a light, medium, or high intensity workout from cleaning their home and by using the things in your home as gym equipment. This is designed for anybody who is either in shape and wants to stay in shape, or who's looking to get into some sort of shape. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to talk to you about all the things that I use to get in shape and get a workout while I'm cleaning my home. Obviously, vacuum cleaner. It's standard. There are a number of things you can do with a vacuum cleaner to get a very good workout. Number two, washing your floors. It doesn't seem like you can get a good workout washing your floors, but I found a way that you can really get a very nice workout by doing this. But instead of having to buy a gym membership fee or buying gym equipment, you could actually use things such as a milk jug filled with water or milk with a belt through it for using curls. And for those of you, whether you're a guy or girl, who want to get a really intense workout, you could add boots, heavy boots. They probably weigh about 5 pounds a piece. You add boots to your workout because it adds weight to your legs and makes you work harder. And you can add weight to a backpack and wear that backpack. What that does is it makes your body work harder to accomplish the same tasks, and therefore you're burning more calories. I'm also going to use things such as chairs to show you how you can get an extremely good workout, same quality as a gym, by doing certain things with chairs. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start my workout with a warm-up. Every time I clean the house, the first thing I do is I warm up by picking things up. And the reason you warm up is so that you get your muscles a little bit loose and your joints a little bit loose so that you can start your stretching routine. And after the stretching, you can go into some of the heavier exercises. So with that, why don't we get started? This is where I start my aerobic house cleaning, is in the basement. This is where my kids play the most often, and trust me, when they're here with their friends, it looks a lot worse than this. And I used to come down here and say, I can't believe this house is destroyed again, but now I look at it like an opportunity for me to start my aerobic house cleaning workout. What I use this for is picking up in the vacuuming down here is to get myself warm and limber for some of the more intense and harder aerobic workout activities that are going to come. First thing I do when I start, real simple, I just basically pick up all the toys, I walk them over to the toy box, and I put them inside. Of course, I get yelled at if I don't put the dolls in the right spot. And then what I do, as time goes on, and I start getting a little bit warmer, I start moving faster and faster so that I can feel myself getting a little bit of a sweat. I start actually almost sprinting to the toy box, putting some of these toys away. And what that does, gets my heart up, gets my lungs going, gives me a good sweat, and I'm ready to start doing a lot of the other activities. They're going to really start getting me in shape. Now, this basement is sometimes so trashed, after my kids get through playing with it, it takes me about 25 minutes to pick it up. And I'm literally running from one end of the basement to the toy box, throwing the toys inside, grab another handful, and do it again. The first thing that I do when I start cleaning my home is I start picking up. One of the reasons I do that is because as I'm picking up, I'm warming up my body, I'm warming up my muscles, I'm warming up my joints for some of the loosening that's going to come next. Because remember, we talked about what's important in any kind of conditioning routine is a warm-up, stretching, and then weight-bearing and or aerobic cleaning. Now, to get a light warm-up, what I'm going to do, I pick up all of the stuff that the kids left around, and I'm going to walk it over to the sink. For a medium workout, you almost jog things back and forth. And when you want a heavy workout, you're almost going to run things back and forth. You want a light workout, walk things back and forth. You want a medium workout, jog it back and forth. And if you want an intense level workout, run things back and forth. Okay, I finished bringing all the dishes and plates from the living room to the countertop, and now I'm gonna load the dishwasher. Now people have said, how is it possible to get any exercise loading the dishwasher? Let me show you. And I'd like for you guys to try this if you get a chance. Real simple. Take your cups, your saucers, and you do deep squats. And after loading one dishwasher, back and forth, you're doing about 30 to 45, sometimes as high as 50 squats. It's a workout. I don't think I need to load the entire dishwasher, but I'm just trying to get you the idea of what kind of exercise you can get loading a dishwasher. There's always an opportunity for exercise. I just got through picking up my house and moving things from the living room over to the kitchen and then putting them into the dishwasher. That took me, depending, about 10 minutes, 15 minutes, but it also gave me enough warmth in my body that I could start my stretching routine. Now, some of the things that I do in stretching, maybe some people can't do, but you decide for yourself if it's something that you want to do. The first thing that I'm going to do, real simple, I do hip rotations. I usually do about 20 of these one direction, 20 of these in the other direction. The whole stretching routine could take me up to 20 minutes. Next, I'm going to do knee rotations. One of the reasons you're doing this is you're getting blood flowing to those joints so they're not stiff and they move more freely. They prevent injuries. Next, I'm going to do is twists. From one side to the other, to loosen up my hip skin. Hips are a ball and socket joint. Okay, from here, I'll spend time on loosening my arms one way and the next, over the head, and then something I like to tease my family about, you swing your arms in opposite directions. You swing to the side, one's going forward, one's going back, opposite directions. Another one helps you loosen the inside of your legs as well as your hamstrings, and that's by going down into a split. A lot of us can't go down to a full split, I understand that, but for those of us who want to get a more intense stretch, put your hands in front of you and twist your hips from side to side. And when you feel you're ready to move into a split, you simply lower your weight, or you take your weight off of your hands and go into a split. Turn to the other side, and then you drop your weight onto your hips and move your body forward. Okay, let's talk dusting. I know most people think I'm not going to get any type of exercise from dusting, but that's not really true. You can get a great workout for your quads, for your glutes, and for your upper body by dusting. It just depends on how you approach it. First thing, instead of just using one arm and doing it this way, consider this. Spread your legs apart, put pressure on your dust cloth, and move from side to side, because then you're going to work your quads, your backside, and your upper body, your triceps, your deltoids, your laterals, and your pecs. Now, considering how many surfaces you have in your home you can dust, combining that with maybe doing the mirrors and the windows is going to give you one heck of a good workout. Once again, it's up to you and it's up to your attitude. Okay, Steve Markovich with Aerobic House Cleaning back in. Little heads up about attitude. I contracted poison ivy, last week on Thursday. Today is Wednesday. I'm not joking. It is bad. I know it's gross, but let's talk about attitude. Let's talk about a little bit of attitude. I made a doctor's appointment. The doctor gave me a shot in the hip of some steroids,
went to the drugstore and got a, some kind of a steroid packet. Take 6 the first day, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, all that night, and some cream. But I asked the doctor, hey, could I exercise? Could I work out? He said, yeah, sure. You okay? Nothing hurt? No, I'm fine. So I'm working out today. One of the reasons why I'm working out today is because I haven't worked out in a couple days, and I had that feeling like, man, I had better start working out. Because if I don't work out, I start getting lazy. And lazy was this. Last night, didn't feel like working out. And instead, I made a peanut butter milkshake, 4 scoops of vanilla, 3 huge teaspoons or tablespoons of good natural peanut butter, some ice cubes, and some vanilla. Good. But today I promised myself I'd work out. It's too bad I don't feel good. Remember, check with your doctor before you do anything. Attitude. It's about doing something when you don't want to do it because you know it's good for you and it's doing the right thing.
Now, let's move on to the next event. Okay, let's talk about windows and mirrors. People wonder, how could you possibly get any kind of exercise cleaning a window or a mirror? Simple. Instead of just wiping it down the easy way using one hand, consider using squats and side-to-side motions. Up and down. Up and down. Or side to side. Using your laterals and your gut and your quads. May not seem like much, but think about how many windows and mirrors you have in your house. Just doing the windows and mirrors alone could be a workout in itself.
Look at these windows, baby. Back-to-back motions, really working the legs. On your squats, up and down. The whole nine yards, man. Up and down, back to back. Yeah, baby. Something else that I'm doing when I'm washing and working all this stuff, I am blasting music so loud, I'm surprised I don't break these windows. I'll play anything from country to Motown to Amy Winehouse. I don't care who it is. I just want to have some music going. Or I'll knock off the music and I'll just watch my emails if I got some kind of a presentation coming in or something. I'll do that. Or just check on my stocks. Who knows? All I got to do, baby, is get with it. Keep going. Never stop. Now back in the 2002 film that I did, when I compare the 2009-2002 and the 2002, I said just doing the windows in my house is a workout in itself. If you do them like the aerobic house cleaning lifestyle says to do them, and you should be doing them, you could bust your ass, you could bust your butt doing those things. Back and back movements, or working your quadriceps. If you got an apartment, same thing applies. Matter of fact, if you're serious about this, you fly me out to your place, you give me something to eat, and I'll put you through a complete workout for your home. I will. Email me, steve@aerobichousecleaning.com. Up and down with the windows, man. Work out them legs. I'll demonstrate that side-to-side motion. Squat down low, shift your weight back, forth. See that? How I'm moving back and forth, guys?
Now, let's go on to the next one. Okay, now it's time to do the mirrors and the windows of the house. And what I do is I use a regular glass cleaner, one that doesn't streak. I apply it. But instead of just wiping the mirror down in a nice, easy way, I put my body into it. I figure if I'm going to do this, I'm going to really work it. And what I'm doing is I'm, again, working my butt, my quads, my calves, and my arms. Now, considering all the mirrors that I have in this house and all the windows that I have in this house, that alone, believe it or not, just doing the windows and the mirrors in this house is a complete workout in and of itself.
And that same thing, and that same movement goes for all the different mirrors in your house. There's no excuse not to get physical activity Hear me breathing? That's all you gotta do. And the moment you get that little sweat going, you start to feel that little warmth coming on your sweat, and that's it, baby. That is the feeling that you want to get. That is it. Get that little sweat going, man. That's it. I'm starting to sweat. Put the toilet seat down with my foot.
Okay, now I'm going to clean the shower. My wife's very happy that I've added this to the aerobic house cleaning program. It's really simple. What I did do, though, is so that you could see what I'm doing is I remove the shower doors. I use a grout cleaner and a towel cleaner. Real simple, so I spray it. But when I'm working it, I lower my body to the floor and then back up again and press hard on the grout. What this does, it works my butt. It works my quadriceps at the same time. And all I do is complete the same motion over the entire shower. Pressing as hard as I can. And then after the walls are done, I come out and I do the shower floor. I use the same towel and grout cleaner, but the movements that I use to get it clean are basically going back and forth to work my abdomen again. Out and back. Out and back and out and back. What that does is puts a lot of pressure on the floor itself, helps get it a lot cleaner, a lot faster, and that makes my wife very happy. Now let's move on to the next event. People think you can't get exercise cleaning countertops, but you can. Depends on your attitude and how you approach it. Instead of just wiping it down using easy moves, put some effort into it. Spread your legs apart a little bit. Move from side to side. You're working your quadriceps, you're working your butt. Press down on your paper towel. What that's going to do is it's going to work your shoulders, your laterals, and your triceps. Now, considering how many countertops or surfaces you have in your house, just cleaning the countertops alone is a nice, good, light workout. Now it's time for the countertops. And how I clean all the countertops in my house, in the kitchen, in the bathrooms, in the bedrooms, or wherever, I use a solution that has an antibacterial ingredient inside of it. But rather than just sit here and take my time and do a nice light wiping, I decided I'm going to really get into this. So what I do, I take this cloth and I really wipe as hard as I possibly can so that I'm working my upper body, I'm working my triceps, my biceps, my deltoids, my shoulders, and I'm cleaning the entire counter this way. Sometimes I can press hard enough that I can actually lift my feet up off the floor. But I'll tell you something, it gets the entire countertop really clean, really fast, because you're really putting your body into it. Okay, now we're going to talk about, and I'm going to demonstrate how you can get a light, medium, or intense workout by using the vacuum cleaner. Some of the easiest things that people know of is the lunge, where you step forward one leg, vacuum, and then the other leg. Now, maybe not seem that like much, but when you do your entire house with this, it's a good workout. A medium exercise with this could be a hip twist, where you're twisting from one side to the other. And work in the midsection. An intense one, and I call this a side to side, and it's pretty advanced, but if you're loose and you're limber and you can do it, go for it. It's where you squat down and you shift your weight from one side to the other, move forward, almost like a crouch walk. Now, it takes me about 25 minutes to vacuum my entire house, and just my vacuuming alone could be an entire workout. I don't need anything else. Okay, I picked up the basement, and now it's ready to be vacuumed. A couple things that I do with the vacuum cleaner to get me warm and prepared for the next movements that are to come. Well, first of all, when I start to vacuum, I go, well, why should I just push the vacuum? You know, what is that going to give me? So what I started doing to give me a good workout, I started doing lunges. I figured, hey, I'm going to vacuum it. Let's make it fun. Let's get some exercise. So what I do is I do lunges all across the basement floor. I simply alternate legs and make sure that I'm really working my calves. I try not to put my knee past the point of my shoe because that puts too much stress on the knee. All I do, back and forth. And I do this for the entire house. Matter of fact, if I just vacuum the house, that's perfect workout. I don't need any more than that. But because I'm limber, I could do an advanced technique that I invented, which is called the side-to-side motion. And it's real simple. When I'm vacuuming, I just go side to side. Keep my body low to the ground, work my calves, my quads, my butt, and loosen my hips. Real simple technique, but man, it really works out hard. This is also the side-to-side movement. Really nice when you're doing edging around the walls and the corners to pick up the dirt, because you're right down by the edge and your edge tool is actually working and doing the things that it should be doing. Okay, now I'm going to vacuum under the couches. When I first started doing this, I had to move the couch, then vacuum it, then put the couch back, scratch the floors. So I decided, hey, why don't I just use this as an opportunity to get some workout in? So what I do now is I basically just grab the couch, I lift it, I stay on my knees, grab my vacuum cleaner, and I vacuum under the couch. It just takes a few seconds, and any money I find under here is mine. And when I'm done, put the vacuum cleaner to the side and put the couch down. Now, if I want to get a little more workout, what I'll do is I'll grab it and I'll do some military presses with it, strengthening my shoulders, my triceps, chest, and my back. I might knock out, I don't know, not that heavy, you know, maybe 15, 20, 25. But when I want to put some more weight on my shoulders, I'll have my kids sit over here or at that end. If they're sitting over here, there's more weight on my shoulders. And what they do is they basically hang on. They're getting an amusement park ride and they're laughing all the way. So it's a win-win for everybody. And that's what I do. And then after I'm done at this couch, I'll move on to the next couch or the love seat and continue at that until the house is done. Stairs. You can get a great calf exercise by doing stairs. Again, it's all your attitude and all how you approach it. What I'm trying to do is give my calves a nice workout. When I do my stairs, I lift my calf, I do calf raises, out and back, and lift my heels. And notice that my heels are going below this level, so I'm getting a full extension on my calves just from vacuuming the stairs. Then I proceed to the next level. Same thing, out and back, out and back, out and back, out and back. I have in my home probably 30 stairs. Just that alone gives my calves enough of a workout. I don't really feel like getting out of bed the next day. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna vacuum my stairs. But while I'm vacuuming my stairs, I'm going to work out my calves. I'm going to do calf raises just like I did at the gym and just like I did in kickboxing and gymnastics. Why I like my calves strong is that when I'm carrying my kids or carting them around, if we're going through the park, my legs are stronger and I'm able to carry them a little bit longer. What I do, real simple. Whenever I vacuum a stair, I move back and forth and I do calf raises with each stair. I've got about, oh, I don't know, 30 stairs in this house. So if I do 3 calf raises per stair, that's about, what, 90 to 100 calf raises. One of the things that I do too, just like all the other movements, is at the very top of the movement, I squeeze it. Because what that does is it helps work the muscle to failure. And when you're working the muscle to failure is when you get the best results. And I just keep continuing until I'm all done with my stairs. Something else that you could do with a vacuum cleaner is when you're cleaning or vacuuming under chairs or couches or beds, is to use that as an opportunity to get some work on your quads using a squat. So instead of just bending over and looking underneath it, you actually lower your body weight, drop down and squat, back up, and squat, back up and squat. Okay, now I'm gonna do the bedrooms, and most importantly, I'm gonna clean under the bed, because under the bed, if it's not clean, it's a house that doesn't feel clean. Two ways that I do this. One is by using squats. It works my calves out. At the same time, get a great workout, get under the bed nice and clean. Another movement that I use to clean under the beds, something called the side-to-side motions, where I'm working my hips and my quads and my calves at the same time that I'm cleaning under the bed. Real simple movement, not rocket science. And considering that I've got four bedrooms in this house, just doing that alone is a pretty good workout. Let's talk about how you can get some really good exercise, either a light, medium, or intense exercise routine by cleaning your floors. A couple of ways to do that is using one, a mop head, and this follows the same patterns that you use while you were doing your floors. By vacuuming, going out and back with a lunge, working your quadriceps. Or you can use the twist that we talked about earlier. Or you could do the side-to-side motions, which are pretty advanced. Lowering your hips to the ground and moving from one area to the next. Moving forward in baby steps until your whole house is cleaned. Now it takes me about 25 minutes to clean my entire house, and just cleaning my floors, just the floors alone, could be a workout in itself. We've seen how we can wash our floors, get a light, medium, or high intense workout using a mop. Now we can get the same thing, either a light, medium, or intense level workout by using a bucket, a cloth, and don't forget the knee pads. These can be purchased at any exercise store, any sporting goods store. They're just a couple of bucks. Yeah, I did put some duct tape on these because it prevents me from sliding, and I learned over time that you're cleaning your floors a little bit faster by using duct tape because it keeps you in one spot. Okay, a light exercise can be accomplished using a rag and a bucket. Real simple, not rocket science. You're on both knees. You're supporting your body with one hand, which is working your shoulders and your triceps, scrubbing, coming back, moving over, scrubbing, coming back. So that's a light exercise. By the time you've cleaned your entire house, that's gonna be a nice workout. If you want a little bit heavier of a workout, it's something called a side-to-side. What you're doing is you're wiping the floor down and you're moving backwards, because you're not gonna move into where you just cleaned. So as you're moving backwards, you're wiping this down. What this is really doing is working your shoulders, your triceps, your laterals, and it's really working your stomach muscles and your sides a lot. So considering that it takes me about, it takes me about 25 minutes to clean my floor alone can be a workout in itself. Remember, the light exercise can be using one hand. A harder exercise could be going from side to side with both hands. That'd be medium. Now, if you want more intense exercise, and this is what they call a killer workout on your abs. Both hands on the towel, you go out and back. And what you're doing is you're using your shoulders, you're using your entire front of your body, including your quadriceps, to pull this cloth back in. And if you want to make it even a little more difficult, you could twist your body from one side to the next, to the other side, and then back in. You could tell that I'm getting out of breath just doing this, and this will take me, 3 minutes? Imagine what you'd feel like after 25 minutes doing this. Now it's time to clean the kitchen floor. The kitchen floor helps me get a really good workout for my shoulders, my arms, my back, but especially my abs. What I use to clean the floor is a warm water solution with some vinegar, because that helps bring out the shine, or sometimes I use one of the recommended floor products that are sold on the common marketplace. I try to use rubber gloves if I'm using a solution, but if it's just warm water and vinegar, I don't really. And I try and wear knee pads to protect myself from the floor, because this floor is pretty big, and after I've done it, it takes about half an hour. My knees hurt. If I can't find my knee pads because the kids are using them or they hit them, I use an actual rolled up carpet, which helps pad my knees somewhat. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go through a beginning exercise that I did when I first started doing this until I got strong enough for the more advanced ones. purposes, it's not really water in here. I would basically keep one hand down here to support me, stretch out, wipe, come back, move over a little bit to get the next part of the floor, wipe, and come back. That helps put some pressure on my deltoids, my triceps, my chest, and a little bit on my abdomen. But if I want to get something that's really killer, it's very similar to the wheels that roll out in front of you. What I do, and I try and do this for the whole floor, and I can't make it yet, the entrance areas where I start to peter out, I do it a complete extension along the entire floor. I just go straight out in front, which works my front side, or I'll go to this side and work my oblique, and then back this way to work my oblique. And I continue this for the entire floor. It takes me about half an hour to 40 minutes to do the entire floor. And in that time, I probably completed about 100 to 150 of these, and my stomach could really feel it. And it's just real simple. This is not rocket science. For an advanced technique, out, hold it, and back. Move over, clear the next part of the floor, out, and back. Turn to the side a little bit to get the oblique. Turn to the other side to get the other oblique, and back. Or if I'm starting to get tired, I'll use a beginning movement, and that's support myself with one hand, out, back, out, and back. And I'll switch arms to make sure that I'm getting a workout on each side of my body that's balanced. After I'm done with this, I feel like I deserve, and I can eat a whole pizza, but the calories that I burn will probably just take it off me anyhow. Okay, the house is clean, the whole house. Now, you want to know, how are you going to get any exercise that your house is clean? Well, consider this. You got the house clean, you did a beginning, intermediate, and advanced exercises from cleaning your house. You can get the same thing just by using the stuff that you have in your house for exercise. And the first thing that we're going to do to get warm, remember we warmed up first? You walk. It's real simple. You got legs, God gave you legs and some feet. You're going to get your blood flowing. You're going to get your muscles warm. You're going to get your joints warm. This is what I do. I walk around. When I want a light workout, I walk. Walking is essentially a light workout. And I make a game of it. Now I'm going to even go off camera. I'm going to tease the cameraman. If I want to make it a little more intense, like a medium workout, I'll start running. And I'll start moving very, very fast. And you'll probably hear me breathing heavier and heavier. That's what I do.
Talking about, if there's anything at all that you can do to get your heart rate going and get a sweat, start walking and running. I got my pants on that I've been grouting with. I've got my wrist weights, 5 pounds each, and maybe I'll start running. Pick a game. Maybe I'll walk. Who cares? Bottom line, do it. As soon as you get that sweat going, as soon as you feel that little warmth in your body, baby, that's when it's working. That's when you got it. That's when you beat your laziness. Sweat, baby. It's about sweating.
all over, back and forth, play a little game of it, touch the walls, run back and forth all the way through the house. Now, when I want to get an advanced warm-up, a couple things I can do. I can use my boots, or I can use this backpack that I stuffed with boots and canned goods that weighs about 50 pounds. I can put that on my back, or you could just run. It has the same effect. The idea of a warm-up is you're trying to get your blood circulating, your body warm, so that when you go into your stretching routine, which I'm going to demonstrate again this time, you lessen the amount of injury and you're able to stretch more. So now that we're all warmed up from walking around, and by the way, my warm-up routine is at least 10 minutes, which means I'll walk around or jog around the house or run through the house. And yes, I know my neighbors laugh at me, but I will do that to warm up, then go to my stretching. So why don't we start on some of the stretching right now? Okay, we just got through warming up. Muscles are limber, blood's flowing, joints are limber. You gotta loosen up to avoid injury. First thing, just like we did during the aerobic house cleaning part, knees in a circle, real simple. Both sides. I do about 20, 25 each way, depending on my mood and how I feel. Same thing with the hips. Hip rotations. Little circles, big circles. Then back the opposite way. My whole stretching routine will take about, depending on the day, between 5, 10, 15 minutes. But you want to get limber. Okay, arms. Pull one arm across your body and hold it for about a 5 count. Same thing with the other arm. Again, only do it enough so that you could feel a little bit of a stretch, but not pain. Over the head, stretching all down the side, then on the opposite side. Same thing. Now, back to the floor. You'll be doing your hips. So what I'm doing is I'm gonna spread my legs a little bit and I'm moving side to side. And I'm loosening up my hips, and I'm going lower and lower to the floor. If you remember, this is a side-to-side routine that we use while we were cleaning the floor, mopping the floor, and vacuuming. It's the same thing here. What that's doing is your hips are a ball and socket joint, and it's rotating them. Okay, now, this is a little bit more advanced, but we're going to go into the splits. And what I'm going to do, maybe I should go sideways, kick off my shoes so that my feet slide. When going into the splits, because they are an advanced exercise or advanced stretching, some people may only get this high. Turn your hips from side to side. Get them nice and loose. And if this is as far down as you can go, that's great. For those of us who are very, very limber, go down as far as you can go, turn to one side, hold it, turn to the other side and hold it. Then lower your body into a full split. And rotate your hips through the split and come back up. Now if your hamstrings and your calves are going to the wall, just like before that we did on that wall, 1 foot in back of you, stretching the back of your leg, your calf, your hamstring, hold it for about a 7 count, and do the other one for about a 7 count. Back again, and back again. I want to demonstrate for people who hips are really tight, how you can get them loose. Let's say that you have a chair, or stool, whatever you got in the house. These are hat boxes. Let's say I'm just starting out learning how to loosen up my hips, and I focus a lot on my hips, because as you know, as we get older, we have a tendency to get hip injuries. Okay. This is as far out as your legs can go. I'm trying to get a good angle for the cameraman. You'll just twist your hips from side to side, keeping pressure on top of the hat boxes. And why you do that is, if your legs start to hurt and they don't feel right, remember there's a difference between pain and injury. You put pressure on the hat box or your chair and push yourself up. Now, if you're a little more limber, you can go down farther. You get a chair that's lower, or hat boxes, or blocks of wood, whatever you want to use. Twist your hips from side to side, and keep going down lower. Now, if you're really limber, I know I always say it, it's not rocket science. You put pressure on the hat box or your chair and go down as low as you can go into one split, goes down as low as you can go on the other side. Then you go down to what's called the Chinese split. Leg straight out, move forward, slide it through. And one of the reasons that we spend so much time limbering, if you've ever seen the guys in the ring, the kickboxers, they're doing a lot of high kicks. Now I know that ladies, you're not gonna be in the ring, but what it does do is it works your legs a lot, gives your legs a lot of strength and mobility at the same time. And it does help prevent injuries, which is why I concentrate so much on stretching. Sometimes stretching could be 10, 15, even 20 minutes of my entire routine but again, I only do stretching, a good stretch, a real good stretch at my age, 54, once a week, whereas before I did it about three times a week. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go through a series of stretching exercises from beginning, intermediate, and advanced that I use darn near every day to keep limber. I also like staying loose and limber because it helps prevent injuries then you can't work out. And also, my kids being 6 and 4 demand a lot of me, so when I'm out playing with them, I could actually participate with them and they love it. One of the first things that I do is I try and loosen my calves. All I do is I find any kind of shelf or platform, I keep my heel on the floor, and I lean into it, and that stretches the calf fully. Then I stretch the other side. And I'll repeat this process until I feel like, yeah, they're getting nice and loose, and I can move on to a lot of other exercises. So that loosened the calf. Now something else that I do, loosen my hamstring and keep it loose, because you always hear about hamstring injuries, and I don't want those. Those aren't fun. I find a surface, put my leg on top of it. What I do is when my leg's up on the platform, I actually push down on the platform, which strengthens and loosens your hamstring, and then I lean into it. Hold it for about a 3 second count. The same thing with the opposite leg. Same thing, I'm pushing down to strengthen and limber this, and then hold and squeeze. Now sometimes what I try and do is put my leg across it and twist my hips into it, so I'm rotating the ball and socket joint completely, so I'm getting a full extension and a full rotation at the same time. Gotta have strong legs. So I'm gonna take you through some beginning, intermediate, and advanced aerobic conditioning exercises. A basic might be just walking up a couple of stairs and down a couple of stairs. And I repeat this until I feel that I'm getting a nice sweat. Now, when I wanna do something a little bit harder, more along the intermediate range, I might do 2 steps at a time, come back down, and 2 steps, come back down. You should be able to hear me breathing. But then when I want a real good workout and really tear my lungs and increase my lung capacity, I'm gonna sprint up these puppies. Man, I'm making sure that I really pump and lift my legs so I get maximum benefits from this. Now I'm going to talk about how you can get some upper body exercise using nothing more than a belt and a couple of jugs of milk. Real simple. It is not rocket science. Simply push the belt through the handles, clip it together. Make sure that you lift what you feel is appropriate for you and after you've consulted with your medical professional. Curling works your biceps. Real simple, not rocket science. Let's say you've got about 16 pounds. You could do a single curl for your bicep. You could use a double curl for your bicep. Real simple. Or you could take that same gallon of milk and lift it, which is working your deltoids and your high neck muscles and high back muscles. Or you could actually keep it in back of you and lift it up for your triceps, deltoids, and your laterals. Now you could repeat this as often as you think. I do about 3 sets of 10 on each, or until I'm tired. Every day is different. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to that side and I'm going to show you how you can get some stomach muscle exercises using your countertops that you just have nice and clean. Okay, now I'm going to demonstrate how you can get a light, an intermediate, or an advanced exercise routine for your abdomen using nothing more than your countertops and your body. Now, a light exercise, make sure you have two level surfaces like these countertops, and you're raising one leg. Put your hand on your side and you can actually feel the muscles contract. Place it on the other side and repeat this as necessary. I might do this about three sets of 30 each, no big deal. And if you want a little bit harder of an exercise, intermediate, hands on your counter, lift your legs up, hold it for about a three count. You can hear me huffing and puffing. Lift them up again, turn to the side, lift them up again, and turn to the other side. Now, if you want an advanced exercise for your abdomen, and again, make sure that you've talked to your doctor before you do any of this stuff, a couple of things. One, you could wear these heavy boots, if you have any heavy boots. These are about almost 10 pounds, 5 pounds a piece, a lot of weight. An L-seat. If you can do it, try it. Make sure you might have somebody in back of you to catch you. Hands firm on the surfaces. And hold for 3 seconds. I could do about three of those for about 3 seconds each because it really works your gut. Now, to work your sides, pretty simple. Make it a game. Open drawers with your feet. People think, boy, that's silly. Is it? I'm 54 years old. I can do that. And then I'll turn around and I'll do the same thing on this side. Okay, what I'm doing now are exercises to help develop your legs, work your oblique that we used to use in kickboxing so that we could develop strength to kick high and strength to kick low. And what I do is I just make a simple game out of this thing. I found these handles on the drawers and I make a game of doing stomping kicks at the low one, progressively higher, until I could go to the cabinets. So what I'm doing when I'm doing this is I'm developing my obliques and my front of my stomach and my quadricep to be strong enough to lift my leg to that height. And then sometimes when I want to annoy my wife, I'll open the cabinets with my feet so she goes nuts. But what this does do is it really does work off those love handles. And if you could get strong enough to wear your legs out, you could just put your hands here and really feel where it's working. Now I'm going to show you how you can get beginning, intermediate, some pretty heavy duty advanced exercises for your upper body using nothing more than chairs. It's real simple. Again, like the milk jug, not rocket science. First thing, nothing more than holding your body and doing dips with your feet on the floor. I'll do three. All the weight for this is primarily on my legs, not necessarily my upper body. When you want to make it a little bit harder, you can put your feet a little bit elevated. And this is putting a lot of weight on your upper body, your shoulders, your laterals, your whole upper body, and you're doing dips. You can also do push-ups using the same kind of routine. Now I'll do about 3 sets of 10, 3 sets of 15 depending. Okay, push-ups. To make them easy, feet are on the floor, chairs apart. Not too hard. A lot of the weight's been taken off your shoulders and put onto your feet. If you want to make it a little bit harder, elevate your feet. Now my wife would kill me if she saw me put my feet on the table, but I'll clean it off. I know how to do that. Knock off some deep push-ups, which is almost mimicking a bench press. Set a lot more of the weight from your body onto your shoulders if you want to get a killer workout. You could elevate your feet onto even a higher surface. And here, there's a significant amount of weight in your shoulders. So depending on your level of fitness, you decide what's right for you. Remember, feet on the floor, feet elevated, and feet real high. Real simple. Now, we're going to walk over to the next routine. Okay, for your shoulders, I'm going to take you through something called planking. It's real simple. You could stand, if your shoulders aren't that strong yet, you can do something called planking. You just hold yourself with a lot of the weight on your knees. If you're a little bit stronger, simply hold yourself like this for maybe a 20, 30, 40 second count, or whatever works for you. If you want to add some other exercise into this, you start doing push-ups. So remember, the transition was from beginning planking, medium planking, now to push-ups. You can do push-ups on your knees, and when you do them on your knees, a lot of the weight's not on your shoulders, so a little bit easier. When you do a regular push-up using putting all the weight on your shoulders, it becomes a little more difficult. Matter of fact, when I wash the floors, often I'll do an area of the floor, knock off 5 or 10 or 15 push-ups. And this is becoming a little more intense. Push-ups on your knuckles. We used to do this when I was in kickboxing. Couple that way. Or if you want to get real extreme about it, and again, this is up to you and your level of conditioning, you can do fingertip push-ups. We used to do these in mixed martial arts to strengthen our ability to grasp. So we went from beginning exercise for your upper body to a medium exercise to an advanced, or what they'd even say for this would be a killer exercise.
Okay, today I'm going to talk a little bit about aerobic babysitting. There's the baby right there. And when you're babysitting, you could actually get some very good exercise. How? Because when you push the baby in a stroller, you push the baby at a good clip, which means you lengthen your stride, you take very wide steps. And if you want to even get more of a workout, you could put on a backpack, weight it down with whatever you want. Bottle of water, that'd be good. Or books. Or, in addition to the backpack, you could add boots. Always wear boots. It makes your legs work harder, and so you get a much better workout. Whoop! Max, come here. Look, look. That's good. To burn fat, remember, breathe properly, find something that you like to do, and do it. God bless your hearts.
I'm helping a guy who owns a bunch of Domino's pizza stores, my favorite pizza, paint the stores, fix them up. Now, that requires climbing up and down, moving from side to side, carrying these Coke trays around. So here's three quick ways where I get good physical activity throughout the day. And a lot of this is about how you approach it. Let's say that I'm painting. I just got through painting these walls. Rather than move my roller up and down, I'm actually going to bend my knees and do squats. Bend my knees and do squats. Now, this is the second store that I'm working on. I've got about 13 or 14 stores to do. So every day that I'm here for the 5 or 6 hours, I'm getting a great workout. Want to go a little crazy and have some fun with it? Do a handstand. If you're really, really in good shape, maybe you want to put some weight bearing on your deltoids and your triceps. How about a handstand? I do it all the time. Okay, my kids are in their teen years, my two daughters, but before they grew up and it wasn't cool anymore, we used to have obstacle courses like this. You had to run around the top of the stairs, run, and then you had to crawl from each chair without falling down. And that was the obstacle course. But that was a game, and we time ourselves. So they'd run around, and they had to make it to here, and then whoever, based on their age, and I made sure that they all won, so that nobody would get upset. We'd give out prizes, or we'd go get a snack or something, and whatever that might be. But you're having fun with your kids, people you love, and then they start getting initiated and ingrained into, hey, it's not working out, I'm having fun. I mean, do you remember the days when it wasn't working out and you're having fun? Well, I like to have fun in my life because I'm too old not to have fun. So this is fun. Aerobic house cleaning is fun. Getting in shape and getting physical activity for me is fun, and I hope it is for you too. God love you. Okay guys, let's talk about how you can get some aerobic exercise when you have a senior moment. And trust me, if you're a baby boomer, we've all had them. So that said, let's describe one. I've got to go into the basement and I've got to get my X. So I'm going to go in the basement and get it. But wait, when I get down here, I forget what it is that I wanted. What did I want? You start looking around. What did I want in the basement? I can't remember. Let's see. Man, I came down here for something. What did I come down here for? And then you forget. So that gives you an opportunity to run back upstairs. And when you get back upstairs, that's when you remember. So let's go. Oh, that's right. I wanted to go downstairs and get my drill. Oh, that's right. So you ran up the stairs and now you get back. Now you get to run back down the stairs and then run back up. It's called a senior moment, an aerobic senior moment. And there's the drill that I needed to get. And you run back upstairs. Yeah, baby, I'm loving it. So even having a senior moment allows you to get some aerobic exercise. Take care. God bless y'all. Okay, folks, they talk a lot about obesity and that it's now a plague in the United States. And this is information from the Centers for Disease Control, you can see. And I'd like you to take a look at how obesity has increased since 1985. Hit play. Here it is. The color coding is no data, less than 10%, 10 to 14%, 15 to 19, 20 to 24, 25 to 23, and above 30. Watch, since 1995, how obesity has increased.
2009, look at the obesity trends in the United States.
How'd I get here?
This is the government. Is your refrigerator running? You better go catch him.
For a number of years, I taught Christian doctrine to third graders, and it really helped me learn a lot about the message that Christ had, and this applies to folks who are heavy. Matthew 9:13, God says, go and learn the meaning of the word mercy. Sacrifice is good, and that's good. Sacrifice is good, but mercy is what pleases me. Now, how does that apply to folks who are struggling with losing weight? Because not only do we have to be merciful to others, but we've got to be merciful to ourselves as well. It is absolutely imperative that for us to be fruitful, we've got to have mercy and forgive ourselves for when we screw up. And I'm talking about the binge eating or the drinking, or if you're doing drugs, whatever that might be. But you've got to show mercy, because it's funny. The more merciful we are with ourselves, I'm convinced, the more merciful we can be with others. We can't use that as an excuse, though, and lie to ourselves and say, well, you know what, I'm not going to work out this week, and I'm just going to eat my face off, and I'm just going to eat and do nothing and lay on the couch. That's bogus. That's a sin. That's a big sin. Because then you can't go, oh, I'm sorry for it, because you're really not sorry for it. But if you're really sorry for it, forgive yourself and be merciful for yourself. Be merciful to yourselves, ourselves.
And remember, that's Matthew 9:13. That's one of my favorite quotes from scriptures. Matthew 9:13. Sacrifice is good, but mercy is what pleases me. That's pretty outstanding. Check it out. Good luck. The biggest blessing I think we all have is my grandma. I used to tell this to my mom, and my mom would tell it to me. They go, Stevie, if you have your health, you have everything. You know, back when growing up, I'm like, yeah, right. Get out of my head here. But the bottom line is if you do have your health, you do, in fact, have everything. Because without your health, you're screwed. Take care of your health, guys. Buy Aerobic House Cleaning. Buy the DVD. It rocks and rolls. Over and out for now. Okay, I am almost done for the day. But just a couple of, something to leave you guys with. If, for those of you who are really, really struggling with losing weight, please consider listening to some of the spiritual folks on the radio. You've got Dr. Dobson, you have a number of AM stations. Insight for Living is one of them. If you're Catholic, there's something called Sacred Heart Radio, and a lot of the folks on there talk about helping heal those who are broken, and by broken I mean are at their wits' end in dealing with certain types of challenges that they're facing in their life, whether that's alcoholism, drug addiction, no matter what it is, obesity, can't lose weight. Oftentimes the solution, a real lasting solution, is not going to come from out in the world. It may be residing in a spiritual walk with God. And I know I bring up scripture a lot, and I'll get teased a lot for that. But the bottom line is this, folks. If you're struggling and nothing's worked, and I'm wondering, 200 million Americans cannot get into better health, cannot lose weight, you know what? Try God. Read the Bible. Read what it says. Listen to some of these men and women on the radio who've had some extremely hard difficulties to overcome. They tell their story about how their life improved once they had or found their relationship, their personal relationship with Jesus Christ, and what it meant to them. Not just in overcoming their challenge, whether it's alcoholism, drug addiction, being overweight, obese, but understanding that that is going to be a path for them. And they know that, and they live that, and they live that every day. And there's your comfort. You're not going to be comforted 2 years from now when you lose 50 pounds or 100 pounds. You're comforted the moment that you begin your walk and your relationship with Christ to solve your problems. Tell you what, if you don't believe, give it a shot. At least give it a shot. This will be my last blog on forgiveness for today. And in, next week's video blog, not sure exactly. I think I'm going to be talking about foods and overcoming or just simply eating better, getting away from unhealthy foods, and why that's so, so important, especially the high fructose corn syrup, which the bottom line of that stuff is crap. But I'll go into that more later, as well as a couple of other things. You guys take care of yourselves. Love yourselves, be merciful to yourself, forgive yourself, and enjoy your life starting now. Right now. Not later. Now. Right now. Take care.